What is up, guys? My name is Mario, and on this video, we're going to check out five reasons why you want to skip the City Blade C-Max phone. Now, City makes a great line of phones, probably one of the best budget phones you can find in the market at the moment. This video is focused for those people that have never used a similar phone before and things that you need to consider before you buy the phone. So let's go check it out right now. Now, number one, we have the low performance on this phone. The biggest disappointment on this phone is the 2 GB of RAM. Now, I wish this phone actually came with at least 2 GB of RAM, because this actually affects the performance on how much you can multitask on a phone. For example, if you're trying to open multiple apps at the same time and trying to go between one and the other, or if you're trying to use one of the apps that uses a lot of memory, the phone is gonna be impacted on the performance. And I was amazed on all the feedback that I got from a lot of people that actually use this phone on how much they were disappointed on this phone because of the performance. Many other people actually experienced issues with the apps actually crashing when they were using this phone. So definitely, if you're thinking about multitasking, playing advanced games, and doing a lot of things on this phone, this may not be the best phone for you to have. I think at this time, every phone should at least have 3 GB of RAM, because a lot of the applications are gonna start using some of the features that are gonna require more RAM to use on a phone. Now, reason number two is the location of the speaker on this phone. One of my biggest pet peeves is having the actual speaker on the back. And the reason is because most of the time when you're using the phone, you're gonna actually hold the back of the phone with your hand, and that's gonna block the speaker. Also, when you lay the actual phone down, you're actually gonna sit it on its back, and that's actually gonna block the speaker itself. And as a result, that's gonna impact the performance and the sound quality. So definitely, if you're looking for a phone that is gonna give you awesome, great sound quality, this is not gonna be the phone for you. Now, reason number three is the size of this phone. Now, this one is going to offer you a 6-inch display, so that is great. But one thing that you have to keep in mind is that this phone is going to take a lot of room, especially if you have to carry it in your pocket or in your bag. Also, let's keep in mind that you also probably want to put a case on it, which is going to make this phone even bigger. Now, it doesn't weigh a lot, so that is great. But if you're used to using your average screen size phone, this may not be the phone that you want to have. I currently am using the SA Plus, and I have used the Note series before, so I'm used to using large screens. And I have large hands, and I'm currently having a hard time using this phone with a single hand. So most of the time when I'm typing or when I'm just surfing through the screen, I have to use both hands, one to hold it, one to just scroll through. So it's really hard to use single hand functionality on this phone. So keep that in mind. On reason number four is the poor performance of the camera in low lighting. Now, don't get me wrong, this phone actually has a dual camera in the back, a 16 megapixel, 2 megapixel, and an 8 megapixel front facing camera. But the issue is, if you're thinking about taking some late night shots, you're not gonna get the best picture quality. In fact, you're gonna get some poor performance, especially if you're going out with your friends late at night to the club, to the bars. You're gonna have to make sure that you're taking pictures and on some well-lit scenarios. Else, this is gonna be a huge disappointment if you're thinking about using this phone when you go out late at night. Now, on reason number five is the non-removable battery. Now, you're gonna tell me, Mario, are you crazy? This phone actually has 4,080 milliamp battery, one of the biggest batteries the phone can probably have around these days. In fact, probably one of the biggest batteries on a budget phone. That is true, but a lot of people actually like to have a removable battery phone, because after 5 months, 6 months, after a year, the battery is not going to perform the same. So a lot of people like to just buy a new battery, slap it on the phone, and just go back to having 100% of the battery life that they got when they got the phone. Also, some people actually like to have extra battery just laying around where they can charge up. So if they go out on a trip, or they actually go out on business, they don't have to worry about recharging the phone. They can always have some extra batteries they just can slap on the phone. And I can tell you that is a fact, because I had a lot of people tell me this before when they're actually, I have made reviews on all their phones. So keep that in mind if you're thinking about getting this phone and you really need a removable battery on your phone. All right, guys, these were my five reasons why you want to skip this phone. Now, this video was not to bash on the phone. In fact, I think this is a great phone. That's why I made another video, which I'll have a link here, telling you five reasons why you want to buy this phone. Let me know what you think about this phone. Do you think these five reasons were legit? Do you think I was incorrect? Let me know in the comment section below. I would love to hear what you have to say about this phone. Thank you for watching. Make sure you hit the like button if you enjoyed this content, and consider subscribing for a weekly tech video.